talking about writing, photography, design, video editing, any of that. Today's video is not about content creation, it's not about the usual topics you hear other freelancers talk about on YouTube. This video is going to be so exciting for those of you who are just looking to start out and maybe a little bit confused about the fields available to you to start freelancing in. A couple of them require very little skills as such, and some of them are based on interest. Now, when I was starting to work on this video, I just found out that there were so many options. I realized that there were so many options that very few people were talking about. And we usually just stick with the usual creative part where we're discussing writing or editing or photography, design. And I just want you to consider some of these fields that are right for freelancing, especially at this time, since you know you may have some time and you may be looking for a second income. And it could just be exciting and fall in your interest bucket. And I discovered that there are so many options which I cannot all combine into one video, which is why I'm going to be splitting this video into two, and I'm going to be discussing the second part of freelance fields for you to consider on next Thursday. So do stay tuned for that one. And in today's video, I'm going to break down the top three freelance fields that I think it's really worth your concentration when you are beginning. And I'm really excited to bring this forward for you because some of this is based on personal experience. I'm really excited. So welcome on board. Welcome to Write Rituals. You're speaking with a freelancer who's been in the business for 6 years, and this is the right channel for all freelancers, beginners or experienced. So with no further ado, let's discuss the first freelance field that you've yet to consider. I want you to think about becoming a voiceover artist. It's not really as often discussed as you may think it should be, considering the number of videos going up, the number of jingles that are required, and the number of people who have voices. So I think this is something that requires very little in terms of upskilling. Of course, you get better as you work more on it. And let me show off a little and stay tuned for the next 30 seconds. Tell me what you think about this.
Black, because it is the color of depth, of sophistication, of elegance, of mystery. White, because it is the color of light, of joy, of purity and radiance. Dark and light together, because there is no beauty in the chaos of color, without the darks and lights, the blacks and whites. We are the shadows that make this carnival of color come alive.
Now, if the voice sounds familiar, which it should, it's because I voiced it over. I made this video as an intro to a fashion show that I was directing way back in 2015. And it was really exciting for me to work on this. And it's personal to me because I had this dream of one day narrating an audiobook. And I just used this video to get myself a couple of voiceover works. And I was working at a place that offered these options actually, and we had lots of clients who required videos. So I wasn't actually even thinking about it seriously, except having this far off dream. But now, you know, I'd be so excited to start a podcast, to narrate an audiobook. So if you guys are working on anything like that, give me a call. And this is something that you definitely should be considering, you know, with all of the marketing going on. Let me know if you've tried it out. How has your experience been? And if you are experienced, then let me know if it is an efficient way of making a freelance income, a second income. So that's the first option for you to consider today. Now, you might not associate freelance with health, and it's a good thing because the caveat that goes along with it is that you have to have some qualification and prior experience to starting off as a health coach, because this obviously means that you have the health, physical and mental, of a lot of people, of your clients, in your hands, and that is a big responsibility. Now, there's various ways of becoming a health coach, and frankly, I think health is having, the industry as a whole is having a huge moment at this time. And it's a good thing. But one of my friends has hired a coach that he was already familiar with, and the price that he's hired him at, this person is walking off, if he has 5 or 6 clients like my friend, he's walking off with a cool 35,000 to 40,000 every month. You have people associating with platforms like YourFit, Healthify Me, Goki, etc. And now you have to consider that if you are becoming a freelancer in these fields, there is a difference in rates for association with and affiliation with platforms like the ones I've mentioned. And that is a difference for you going on as a solo artist, solo artist, health artist. There are a couple of other fields that you could consider within the health coach option. So one of them is as a dietitian, and this is very exciting because I've seen this young lady come up so quickly within a year, establish a whole business of sorts by having an Instagram showcase. Seriously, she is now partnered with CureFit, I think, not Healthify Me at this time, and it's only based on her Instagram feed. And she hardly started about a year ago, shortly after getting married, and she uses this traditional with a twist sort of cooking to bring health into people's homes. She has this amazing showcase. I'm going to link her down below because I love following her, and I messaged her before this video asking if I could direct some of you to her page, because I enjoy that sort of entrepreneurial spirit that people are showing and making use of these channels to showcase. And that's something for you to consider if that is to your interest, because it requires very little upskilling. And it's something that is very necessary for all of us. Food is necessary. And yeah, that's one for you to consider. Again, within the health bucket falls this one, which is yoga. And people who have been interested in yoga have become freelance yoga coaches during this lockdown. I've seen quite a few of them mushroom all over the platforms, but also as solo yoga teachers. I'm seeing a lot of traction in that field as well, so that's one for you to consider. And the last one within the health bucket that I'd like to discuss is meditation. Now, so that the thing with this sort of coaching is that it's not very time intensive necessarily. That is actually charged at high prices. It is a high ticket client base of sorts. So I know there's a lot of free apps and guided meditations out there, but I am seeing that this is a good freelance option as well, because I'm seeing a lot of people get into the coaching field right now. So that's the whole health bucket. I hope you consider this. If this is to your interest, I think it's a really great option for those starting out, those slightly interested. You could take a lot of people along on your journey this way. Now, I know that I've mentioned platforms in my last video as well, and if you haven't watched it, I think you should. I discuss how to get clients in that one. So I know I mentioned talking about freelance platforms, and I am working on it. It's just that when I started the work a couple of weeks ago, I discovered that there were so many platforms that very few of us knew about and were talking about, that I wanted to do justice to it, and I'll bring it up next week. So stay tuned for that. That's again going to be very content heavy, and I hope you can take back a lot from that video. But discussing other freelance options for you to consider, consider this third one. One thing I did notice with that, with a lot of trends that are being followed even in India right now, is that a lot of the younger crowd is getting into minimalism and is looking at decor ideas such as Yuga and Scandinavian style and things that are more trendy online. And there is still a lot of room for mixing traditional and modern design elements. I think vernacular architecture and design is still something that is very valuable, because as an interior decorator, understanding the person and their lifestyle becomes so important, and I think it's a very personal connect that you build with your client to be able to deliver on their demands as an interior decorator. So if you like people and if you like decorating, I think that that's something you should probably invest in. It does require a little bit of qualification experience, yes, but you know, there's so many softwares today available to you, so you can just wow your client with 3D models showcasing how each piece would look in that intended space. And it's just become a lot easier to go into foray into creative fields like this, which you probably did not consider even 3 years ago. And with real estate markets being down, I understand that there may be some hesitation, but it's a very good time for you to start, because it's going to boom again soon. No one's going to stop buying houses regardless of whether the virus lasts 2 years. So I am personally very excited about seeing the freelance fields grow and blossom, because the aggregators have multiplied, but this also means that the industry as a whole is doing well. I think becoming a freelancer will give you the application perspective of all of that knowledge, and will make you even more interested to keep on learning. So keep learning, keep freelancing, and reach out to me at hello@writerswords.com if you are looking for any freelance coaching or consulting. And I really appreciate the time you took to watch my video today, and I'll see you in the next one, Thursday. So stay tuned.